Association. We started this last year, September 2015, really as a means of driving conversation, engagement, collaboration, and hopefully investment into the whole space of VR and AR. I think we're still in that early days, the phase one approach, where it's a lot of experimentation. We're seeing a lot of hardware put into market, obviously the headsets, from everything from cardboard to Samsung Gear through to Oculus Rift, HTC Vive, you name it. But it's now the next bit is the content and the utility, the purpose of this. Where's it going to be in terms of application? Well, yes, there's a lot of buzz around marketing and the application of both VR and AR. And, you know, we've seen some interesting brand executions from everyone from Coke through to Lockheed Martin and this virtual tour of Mars that they took these kids across in a bus. You know, the challenge with marketing is its sustainability. We want to ensure that I think that brands just don't go into it and treat it as a gimmick, that it is something that's a continuous area of growth and experience. It has to be something that brings value.
It's interesting for us as a consultancy. We need to be on the forefront of technology so we can educate our clients and add more value to campaigns. We're currently working with many clients on VR and AR executions. I think with auto clients, you know, there's a real opportunity for different brands to actually immerse themselves into those environments. We find that with luxury clients too, there's a lot of opportunity there as well.
I'm Mitru. I work at RGA. RGA is an advertising agency. Within the advertising agency, I build prototypes. The reason I come in, the reason engineering team is within an advertising agency is because the ad world is kind of moving towards evolving ways of advertising and using technology for campaigns. VR and AR are some things that the advertising industry really look forward to and use in interesting ways, I'd say, yeah.
The packaging that brands have in their billions out there on shelves and in people's cupboards is really a forgotten medium, right? So we believe that is really the most powerful owned media channel there is. And essentially with our technology, what we can do is we can bring that to life and connect consumers with content, utilities, experiences, and also repurchase opportunities that drives business benefit and business value and brand equity.
We're actually working on the world's first sci-fi animated series in virtual reality. So it's like a TV series, but it's all in virtual reality. We created a proof of concept trailer, and we were invited to show it to everybody, which was great.
I think AR is still a lot more functional than... By functional, I don't mean VR doesn't work. I think VR works, but I think AR is a lot more useful at the moment than VR.
One of the main takeaways I took from the panel today is the opportunity of mixed reality, right? So that ability to go from sort of more of an augmented reality type experience into sort of something that's in between AR and VR in this sort of mixed reality type world. I think that's probably, for me, going to be where, you know, we end up over the sort of next 5 years or so.